I think it's a wonderful place. Our county's a special county. Got special people in it too. I said, well, you hear them talking about out west, the farmland blowing away. I said, you go up north, you got put up with ice and snow and blizzards. I said, you go somewhere else and something else wrong. I said, I'm going to stay in Hyde County, just the garden spot of the world.
The crime rate is low, really, and the scenery is pretty. Ain't that many cars and stuff riding back and forth. You can walk up and down the road without worrying about getting hit by a car. And I don't know, it's just the people down here, most of them are nice. And they treat you like you their child, even if you ain't. If they don't know you, they treat you nice.
Tucked in between the Pamlico Sound, the Pungo River, and the Pocosin Lakes of eastern North Carolina are some of the oldest communities in the state. With names such as Scranton, Swanquarter, Nebraska, Englehard, and Fairfield. These communities and the rich lands in between make up the mainland portion of Hyde County.
And my mother used to say that when she was a little girl growing up, that there was a big hill where people had oysters and had piled shells up, and there was a real tremendous high place of shells. And they used to go out there and hunt gulls and chase gulls and so forth, the teenagers. They'd go out there and have them some parties, and that was a kind of a gathering place, and a whole bunch of the teenagers wanted to get together. That's where they got the name Gull Rock. Was because of that rock.
This thinly populated area is wrapped around Lake Matamuskete, the largest natural lake in North Carolina. Hyde County's setting has endowed it with plenty of natural beauty, including state game lands, four national wildlife refuges, and the Pamlico Sound. For decades, these resources have attracted tourists who come to hunt, fish, and watch birds. This setting has also affected the speech of Hyde County. Hyde County shares with other areas around Pamlico Sound a unique accent, similar to that of some areas on the eastern side of the Chesapeake Bay, but different and found nowhere else in the world. It is often called the HYDE TALK accent, or HYDE TALK, and includes a mixture of features that were once found all over eastern North Carolina, as well as other features that developed more recently around the Pamlico Sound. The land that is now Hyde County was settled by Europeans in the first decade of the 18th century. The first part of the county to be settled was the area along the Pungo River, around Scranton and Sladesville. Europeans settled the eastern part of the county after Native Americans were confined to a reservation and began selling their land to English settlers. The origins of the settlers played a major role in determining the features that would later make up the dialect of Hyde County.
Many of our early settlers came from the eastern shore of Virginia, Delmarva Peninsula. A lot of them came from the Norfolk County area. If you look at the early records of those counties, you see the same names that you see here, Early and Hyde. People just, they traveled by water, they settled, and then they moved on. They were not people that came and stayed for long periods of time. Land was cheap, and there was just nothing to tie them to an area. The Spencers came here in the late 1600s. They were royalist supporters of King Charles, and when Cromwell took over, they fled and entered the port of Charlestown, which was for a few years was located near Wilmington and precedes Charleston, South Carolina. The story is that they were in the waters of the Pamlico Sound here near present-day Englehard, and Lady Rose Spencer died, and her husband, whose first name we're not sure of, buried her on lands he designated as a great marsh. And they went on and entered the colony and came and settled here near where his wife was buried.
Until the Civil War, many plantations dotted the fertile lands in the county. One thing that made Hyde County different from many areas farther inland was that small plantations dominated here. This brought African Americans and whites into more constant contact with each other and prevented what happened along the coast of South Carolina and Georgia, where a Creole language called Gullah developed among the slaves. Some plantation houses and other structures from that period still exist.
It was at one time, I imagine, a mighty big plantation. There were two houses, two slave houses here. And but it's dwindled down to just a dwelling now and a small barn and a little house that they was called the
smokehouse,
where they kept their meat, where they smoked the meat and kept it.
The topography and the climate shaped Hyde County's history, making residents dependent on canals and the Pamlico Sound for transportation until well into the 20th century, and cutting the county off from inland parts of North Carolina. As a result, changes in dialect that spread over most of North Carolina didn't reach Hyde County.
Yeah, my daddy was a boatman. He run, I reckon call it a freight boat, because he run from the Nebraska area to Washington. Uh-huh. Well, kind of a freight boat. Uh-huh. He worked on the water quite a lot.
We were isolated, but everybody had a boat. And all you have to do is get out there in Pamlico Sound and you have free reign. You can go to Hatteras, Ocracoke, Washington, Belhaven, and they did. There was really no reason why they couldn't get away from Hyde County if they wanted to. My daddy probably knew more about New Bern than he did Washington. He remembers going to New Bern, and New Bern is probably as close as Washington is, really.
Yes, sir. Isolated by land, but not by water.
Not by water.
It was about 1924 and 25 when they built the road out of Swan Quarter going to Belhaven. And it was later than that that the road to Stumpy Point was built.
Was it just like just a dirt road?
Just a dirt road, and if it rains, you got stuck. Well, we used to dig out of holes up and down the road for a long, long time before we had pavement.
The weather could make the roads impassable in the early days, but it could also shape people's lives in other ways. When a hurricane hit, everybody was affected.
Do you remember the hurricane in 1944?
Oh, yes. It was really bad, and it was, I think I can remember all with children in our breakfast room playing Monopoly, and the chimney next door fell over, and that was a big time when it hit our car. And after the hurricane, it was devastating. Especially on the Outer Banks. And I remember that there were many, many. In fact, I would say most of the homes over there in Buxton, Avon, and Hatteras were washed off their foundations. And it was a really bad time.
Folks always had to work hard to make a living in Hyde County. The county reached its highest population around 1900, when logging was a major industry here. Railroads were constructed to haul out the lumber. After the timber boom ended, though, the population fell and the railroads were taken out. Various attempts were made to drain Lake Matamesquite and farm its bed, but in the end, nature won out and the lake filled up again. Other industries have been more constant. As one might expect from its coastal location, Hyde County has always relied on fishing and other marine enterprises for much of its economy. Although fishing and oystering aren't what they once were, in recent years, crabbing and shrimping have taken up some of the slack. Seafood packing plants are still important employers in the county. Even more vital to the economy of Hyde County is agriculture. The kind of agriculture is another aspect of Hyde County that sets it off from that in the rest of North Carolina. The peaty soils are poorly suited to tobacco. As a result, farmers here have turned to other crops. Corn, wheat, and other grain crops have been so important in Hyde County that it has been called the granary of the South. Cotton has been an important crop since the early 19th century.
And this year, everybody's getting to cotton, so we had a bit of cotton gin down here, and well, the soil is right now to do more cotton. See, before you had to pick cotton by hand,
right?
And that was getting kind of old, so they stopped doing cotton. Went to soybeans and wheat and corn. You put a combine, but now since everybody try cotton. Cotton's going good. They hard. Somebody has to bring a cotton picker down here, sell it, then cut way off in order to process it, whatnot. So now they got, so everybody got together and put up a cotton gin, and we're going from there.
With so many things that make Hyde County different from inland parts of North Carolina, it's not surprising that the dialect of Hyde County and other areas around Pamlico Sound is different too. One aspect of the dialect that is distinctive is vocabulary. Several words that are found mainly in eastern North Carolina are well known in Hyde County.
I guess people around here make pone bread, right?
Made them myself.
Yeah. How did you make it?
I measured out so much meal. Put it in my pan. I put a little bit of salt. I didn't never measure it. I just put a little bit of salt in. And the secret of it is using boiling water to stir up that pone bread.
Oh, pone bread. Yes, we love pone bread. I remember one time, my mother was entertaining for the Episcopal Church, and the president of St. Mary's College was staying here as her guest, and she had pone bread, and he made fun of it. He didn't care for it, and she felt very insulted. But I think pone bread is delicious, and I make one every Thanksgiving and every Christmas. In fact, I've offered to make one for TJ, but Sally said he's not too fond of pone bread.
I like pone bread.
Huh?
I like it.
You like it all right? Oh, I love pone bread.
Shivering owl?
Shivering owls?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yes. A neighbor, when we lived in Slocum area, had a lot of trees in their yard. And the owls used to nest in those trees. We go over visit and sit with them till bedtime sometimes on their porch. And those owls would be, you know, being that, making a funny noise.
Well, they leave the R out, yeah, Irish potatoes. They're trying to say Irish potatoes, and they say Irish potatoes. It's easy for me to say Irish potatoes. Because I grew up hearing people talk about it.
I hear people say Irish potatoes right here.
Irish. Irish potato.
Hear that?
I've heard that lots of times, Irish potatoes.
Mama, I've heard Mama use, yes, a lot. If somebody beat somebody else up, you know, and he mama'd them up.
Mama?
Yeah, the way you heard it.
Well, I would think it was destroyed, ruined. Anything mama'd would be done away with.
Squamish.
Yeah.
Yes, I've heard the word that, squamish. And that's when you have a sick feeling in your stomach.
Toe bag, yeah, toe bag. I got a toe bag to put oysters in. I don't know where it comes from, but.
Yeah, what would a toe bag be?
It's just an ordinary burlap bag. It's a burlap bag.
Yes, I know what a toe bag is.
What would you, how would you define that?
Well, it's a bag that we put produce in and oysters in. We use tote bags all the time. It's made of hemp, isn't it, T.J.?
I think so. Burlap.
Burlap, yes, a burlap bag. Okay. Are you hearing these terms around here for the first time?
Some of these terms are familiar only among the older generation. Changing lifestyles and newer words entering from the outside have made them obsolete.
Yeah.
What is that?
So I couldn't tell you what it is. I heard that before, though.
Is it good? Have you ever eaten it?
I ain't never eat it.
Shivering?
Shivering owl?
Shivering owl. Have you ever heard of a shivering owl?
Nope.
You have no clue what a shivering... Okay.
What outsiders usually first notice about the Hyde County accent is that some of the vowels are pronounced in unusual ways. In fact, some people even think that Hyde Countyans sound like Australians.
The next few features are various vowels. That's the high type pronunciation, so this is I or I. So you can see this means that people around here say I, these two pluses, and this right here means people around here don't say I, like people do in the inland areas. There are various other vowels. Al, traditional pronunciation here is more like I, so you get dang and lied, things like that. That's another Pamlico sound feature. The word bear, well, it sounds something like bear.
These pronunciations are disappearing now. The roads that opened Hyde County to the rest of North Carolina also opened the way for outside pronunciations to displace the traditional accent. The changing pronunciations of Hyde County can be heard in one bit of local lore that is often told in the county, the story of Chet and Tom.
In times of slavery, some white man owns a slave, and he had done something against his will, and he dragged him around behind the horse and buggy until he died.
Uh-huh.
So, and that was always a tale was told about Chet and Thomas.
Oh.
But they were fighting and carrying on, dragging each other behind wagons, and you know, and end up killing each other that particular day. And so, as a result of that, certain time of the year, maybe a week or two, you see lights that goes up in the air and they fight and they fall to the ground and they get back up again and fight again. You know, you can ride over here. But then the lights like way over there, and you ride over there, the different places. You can't ever get pinpoint where the lights are at, no matter how far you go, where you go at.
That about them
some man that owned some slaves or something. His slave broke away or something up in Slocum, and they got fighting or something, and the slave owner chopped off the slave's head or something, and then the slave owner died. And on Halloween night, you can see the glowing balls glow up in the air and it's flop. But I seen it though. I seen it one Halloween night. How the balls really glow up in the, I seen it.
Have you ever heard of Tet and Tom?
Yeah, my dad seen it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So tell us about it. What have you heard
it's,
about it?
It says like fire, flames and stuff in the sky.
It happened up in that Slocum area.
In Slocum.
Mm-hmm. Have you been to through a place called Last Chance?
Uh-huh.
And you're right there where all that group of old stores are. The road from there goes right on up into Slocum area.
The Granary of the South. The Garden Spot of the World. Or simply the road less traveled. Hyde County is a dynamic place whose speech harks back to a time when North Carolina was young. But it's also a place that has undergone fundamental changes in recent years.